What's up, everybody? Welcome to a new English Beat. I'm Katia, and I really hope that you're doing well being in quarantine. In today's lesson, we're going to learn 10 informal phrasal verbs. What they have in common is that they are all nouns followed by a preposition. Are you ready to increase your vocabulary? If so, take a notebook and let's kick off. So let's start with some animal phrasal verbs. The first one is to chicken out. To chicken out. It means not to do something because you are afraid and scared. And now let's look at two examples. The first one, Jim was going to do a parachute jump, but he chickened out at the last minute. Jim was going to do a parachute jump, but he chickened out at the last minute. So finally, he didn't do it. And another example, come on, let's do it. You can't chicken out now. Come on, let's do it. You can't chicken out now. And now let's move on to our second phrasal verb, which is to duck out. To duck out. It has two meanings. The first one is to avoid doing something. And now two examples. The first one, he ducked out of going to the conference. He ducked out of going to the conference. Another example, she ducked out of paying for the lunch. She ducked out of paying for the lunch. And the second meaning of the phrasal verb to duck out is to leave a place without being noticed. For example, she ducked out of the party without saying goodbye. She ducked out of the party without saying goodbye. Let's continue. Our phrasal verb number three is another bird, to crawl over. To crawl over. It means to brag about something. And now two examples. The first one, I can't stand people who crawl over their money and possessions. I can't stand people who crawl over their money and possessions. And another example, she enjoys crawling over her professional success. She enjoys crawling over her professional success. Number four, the phrasal verb to clam up. To clam up. It means to be unable to speak or to refuse to talk about a particular subject. And now a few examples. The first one, it's hard to communicate with him as he tends to clam up. It's hard to communicate with him as he tends to clam up. And another example, he can't help clamming up in social events. He can't help clamming up in social events. It means that he doesn't feel confident when he has to speak with people or in public. Let's continue. Our phrasal verb number five is to pig out. To pig out. It means to eat a lot or too much of something. And now two examples. The first one, it's easy to pig out when you are in quarantine. It's easy to pig out when you are in quarantine. And another example, let's pig out on pizza and popcorn while watching a movie. Let's pig out on pizza and popcorn while watching a movie. To pig out on something, on pizza and popcorn. Number six, the phrasal verb to cloud over. To cloud over. It has two meanings. The first one is to become covered by clouds. An example sentence, it was sunny, but suddenly it clouded over. It was sunny, but suddenly it clouded over. And if your face clouds over, it means that you suddenly become worried. For example, his face clouded over when he heard the news. His face clouded over when he heard the news. Let's continue with a very common phrasal verb, to belt out. To belt out. It means to sing very loudly and with enthusiasm. And now, two examples. The first one, Jess enjoys going to a karaoke bar and belting out. Jess enjoys going to a karaoke bar and belting out. And one more example, the spectators were belting out the anthem. The spectators were belting out the anthem. Let's continue. Our phrasal verb number 8 is to pan out. To pan out. It has two meanings. The first one is to succeed and be successful. For example, he invested a lot of money and effort in his business and luckily it panned out. He invested a lot of money and effort in his business and luckily it panned out. And another meaning is to develop in a particular way. For example, let's see how things pan out next week. Let's see how things pan out next week. Fingers crossed. And to finish, we're going to look at two British informal phrasal verbs. Number 9 is to cheese off. To cheese off. It means to annoy. And now, two examples. The first one, it cheeses me off when people whistle. It cheeses me off when people whistle. And you, what cheeses you off? Let me know in the comments below. And another example, his reckless attitude really cheeses me off. His reckless attitude really cheeses me off. And last but not least, the British informal phrasal verb, to grass on. To grass on. It means to tell the police or somebody in authority about something bad somebody has done. And now let's look at two examples. The first one, he grassed on his boss about paying his employees under the table. He grassed on his boss about paying his employees under the table. And the last example, Jake is in so much trouble as somebody grassed on him to the police. Jake is in so much trouble as somebody grassed on him to the police. So guys, I really hope you enjoyed this English bit and learned some new phrasal verbs. If you did, don't forget to like this video, to hit the subscribe button and do my daily quiz on Instagram. Thanks for watching and see you next week. Hang in there. Ciao!